What's good, TV crew? Noah back on cam with another video. Today's video is gonna be very, very different. Like, I don't even know like how this video is gonna end up at the end, but I know for now it's like, let me just explain, right? Basically, I decided secretly to go on a journey spiritually to figure myself out with Christ. And, you know, trying to get closer to God and figure out what can help me get closer to God and what, like, pushes me away from God and what people, like, you know how it is. This journey has been about, what, six to nine months long. And I can say that this journey was just a big cluster. So much has happened physically and spiritually that I can say at the beginning was just peak. Right now I'm coming to like the climax of it, like I'm coming so close to the end, but because I'm coming so close to the end, I just have something to like say that has just been on my mind, because it's one of those ones. During this journey I was realizing a lot of things, like clocking a lot of things, deepening a lot of things that I was told, but you're not meant to do, you know what I mean? But like, it's not for everybody. I'm now taking my religion seriously, because back then I'm not gonna lie, I can say I'm a Christian but I wouldn't take it seriously, but like now I'm actually taking it seriously. And like, it's one of those ones where it's when I say that, like when people say to me, have you changed, and I say yes, I will actually force the yes, because when I say yes, people like to ask the question again to me, and I don't like repeating myself, because like it actually does get on my nerves a bit. I was gonna get a Bible, but like I just realized it's all the way over there, so I just have my shit here. Oh, excuse my language. Let me explain my journey. So my journey to getting closer to Christ started with basically shambles. Like, it was one of those ones I started from the bottom, do you know what I mean? We've been passed around in bad ways. People will be saying that I'm one way when I'm no, I'm not, blah, blah, blah. Like, I was just being called things, being told things by other people the way I was and all that stuff. And it just irritated me, and it just made me feel like, what's the point of, you know, being here? What's the point of living? Blah, 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 blah. Like, you know what I mean? Brought me to a place of literal suicide. And it just brought me, it just made me think, like, you know, if you have, and I keep saying it to people, like, if you have so much time to talk bad about me, like, then you must be really, like, there's nothing going on in your life. And it annoys me the fact that there is nothing going on in life, because I know for a fact there's something going on in your life. Do you know what I mean? With that, I attempted it. Not kind of attempted it, but I was on my way to do it. But like, a lot of my friends called me, tried to stop me, blah, 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 like verbal. And long story short, here I am today. I say, before that even happened, in my church, we have a youth group chat, like on Messenger, where they call once a week for about 45 minutes to an hour. And I'm going to say here, because I haven't said it to them, the reason why I left the group chat, right, was because I was purely angry at that group chat. The reason why I was angry at that group chat is because there was somebody that was in my choir, I'm not going to name who, but somebody who was in my choir was going through something mentally and spiritually, but in the group chat, because they're all together trying to get close with God and all that stuff, they only dealt with that person's situation in a spiritual point of view. Now, this is in my point of view, was to pray about it, because the person kept seeing a figure all the time, and I would be on the phone and I would see her like scared all the time. Like, the minute she'd even close her eyes, she'd open up and she'd freak out all the way. Like, I'm not gonna lie, it hurt me on a different level, because it was one of those ones where it wasn't just like, it was, she didn't just construct it out of nowhere. Things had to have happened to put it together. And I always say that when two things come together, something will happen. When a guy and a girl comes together, a relationship forms, or marriage forms, blah, 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 a child is born. I've actually asked her, like, yo, how did this start? Blah, blah, blah. She would just be like, she would tell me how it started, but it confused me. But then I'll be like, wait, instead of me asking about how it started, what is what you're seeing telling you? And it would always doubt everything she would say. And it made me really think about her. And I'm like, oh my days. She always doubts herself. Like, no matter what she does, she doubts herself. And she's now constructed that into a spiritual being. So I was like, we have to not only pray on the spiritual side of that, but on the on your mental side as well. But like, help with you on your mental side. Like, always just remember that you're the strong person. You're the one who leads everything in your body, blah, 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 blah. Because in the group chat, they just kept saying that she was, it's just a spiritual thing, it's just a spiritual thing. It just riled me up, and I was like, I'm not dealing with you guys anymore. Because someone did say to me, it was as if like God came, God said, put it on them to say to me. They said to me, if something that's for God is drawing you, is putting you off God, like, leave it alone. And I was like, okay, so I left the group chat because it was really putting me off God. It was really just make, every time I joined that group chat, I would just feel so much like anger. I would just leave the call. And at one point I was like, you know what? I'm leaving the chat. I've left the chat like so many times because there's people that would want me in the chat and they'd want me to at least say something, but I just couldn't because the hatred and the anger that I was feeling was just too much. So I just kept leaving the group chat, kept leaving. Then eventually one of the people in the group chat came to me after church and was like, yeah, after the last time you left, we just decided not to add you back anymore. And in my head, I was like, the first four times I've left should have been your conclusion not to add me back. But you guys, it was like, at that point, they were forcing me to come back into the group chat. And once again, it was pushing me away from God. Because you can't force somebody into something they're not like 100% on. Do you know what I mean? Yeah, we're progressing on with the whole journey, by the way. I was confused for like a week or two. And when people asked me if I was okay, I'd be like, no, my G, I'm just lukewarm. Like, I have no clue what I'm doing. I literally have no clue what I'm doing. I wouldn't know if I'm for God or if I'm not for God. One Sunday, I was like, look, I can't be walking around saying I'm lukewarm, because what if tomorrow I just said I'm lukewarm and 2 seconds later God comes and just takes everybody, and then he just looks at me and said, what are you? And I'll be like, I feel like me personally, the youths in my church are like it's like a race, but it's not like a race where if I see you with me in the race, we're running together. It's one of those ones, it's you're either with me or you're not type race. And it's like, when you do that, you're putting other people off as well. Because I could say, I don't really know anyone in my church that can race for God, but still try to bring somebody with them. Do you know what I mean? And I know everyone's saying like, the end times are coming. But it's one of those ones where if the end times are coming and God wants you to bring people, why are you racing on your ones when you need to race with other people too? Like, just because your best friends or your family members or even your parents are on the same page as you does not mean that there's other people that God wants you to bring with you. Do you know what I mean? A race can't be won. You can't win a race without a team. Do you know, for example, see like F1 car races, right? The car can never... Like, if you want the actual car to win the race, you actually need the team to be able to change the tires, to be able to check the air pressure, to be able to fill you up. Like, do you know what I mean? Like, you need a team of people before you can, like, you know, for God to be like, yeah, you're ready. So on this journey, I took a step back. Because if you don't know, I've done it before. I took a step back, but in a physical point of view. Spiritual point of view, I took a step back. And I was just watching everybody, everyone I know. Even the churches I've been to, I've just been watching. And my friend's group went from a big group, and then narrowed it down to, what's the diagram again? I think it's like a Venn diagram or something. I'm not sure. Where it's like, there's two circles, right? And it comes in like that, and there's just like an oval in the middle. I'm in the middle of two circles as I speak. One circle, you know, they're doing what they can, like, to benefit themselves. Another circle is just a mixed ball of emotions and, like, trouble. I've dealt with that mixed trouble before, spiritually, thanks to God. And I'll explain that story one day, but not in this one. Actually, no, probably in this one. But like, it was like, as I was figuring that out, I was like, okay, cool. Let me just continue with my walk, Let me continue. Further down the line, I realized, because it was like, I felt like I was racing. I just realized, I was like, there's no need for me to race. Like, if I race, I'm actually going to miss out on opportunities. Then, like, I'm actually going to miss on opportunities that I'm going to mess up, than rather getting to the place where it's going to be perfect. If you miss the first time, take it, because you're one step closer to your goal. That's why it's called the mistake, do you know what I mean? I slowed down and I was like, right, okay, let me just like see what my situations are, what's happening here and here. Like, let me even go back to my past, like as to why I'm here today. Like it just made me realize, like, God has been there since day one. Like, since day one. And I was like, wow, God, like, there's actually nothing else I can say to you besides thanks. And because that's all I can give. The way my past was, all I can actually say is thank you for what I have today. Because my past is peak. I'm not going to even lie to you. My past, my upbringing, everything was just very peak. Even recently, it's just very peak. And all I can just keep saying is thanks. So we're going to fast forward a bit to Open Circle. I've been going to Open Circle from like day two onwards. I was going to say day one, but like the first, I didn't even know about it. So like day two, I was going to it, right? And they hosted a thing called Motive, where we all just had a worship and praise session, right? And I'm not going to lie, it was lit. Like, I would love for them to do something like that again, but not called Motive. Do you know what I mean? It could be Motive again, but something like that again, organized by the same people, right? That Tuesday was the day where I said, look, today is just a full stop on what's happening. Because I'm walking around here saying thanks, thanks, thanks. But am I really trying to go out to you? Am I really just saying to you? Do you know what I mean? So I was like, yo, God, today's the day where everything is a full stop. Like, I'm coming to you. Like, you've came to me so many times. Like, at this point, I'm coming to you now, because it's really, you've come to me way too many times. And it's not one of those, like, I feel like it's unfair. It's one of those, like, since you came to me so many times, let me try my hardest to come to you. Do you know what I mean? Holy Spirit. Like, I felt the Holy Spirit so many times. But this one, this day was different. So I have three friends that are in the bad side of the circle, of the Venn diagram. And on my good side, I asked them, like, yo, are these people coming to this Motive? And they were like, I don't know. And one of them said, no, I think. So then later on, we started praying. Like, everyone was praying. I had nothing to pray about, because I realized in the past that when you pray, it's from the heart. People just say it. It's actually from the heart. It doesn't come up with your mind. You pray from the heart, and you also pray the way you pray. You don't pray the way everyone else prays. Like, God, you are... Like, you pray the way you pray. You talk to him because God is your friend. You can, like, the way I talk to God when I pray, it's like, God, you've done so much in my life. I don't know how you do it, but yeah, you just do. And it's just, I thank you for everything you've done. Like, every time I read your word, it's like a new sentence in my life, like a new pathway, blah, blah, blah. Do you know what I mean? I had nothing to pray about, right? And I was just singing along to songs like, you are Alpha and Omega, you worship, you are Lord, you are ready to be praised. Yeah. And one of my friends came up to me and he was like, yo, those people from the bad side of the diagram, from the circle, are here. So I was like, yeah, cool. It was like God was the one, God sent him to tell me this, because the minute he said it to me, I said, boom, I'm talking to them today. You have sent some people to me today to talk to them, and today I'm going to talk to them, because you are the Alpha, you are Omega, blah, 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 blah. Like, I was spitting. Like, I was actually spitting on people. One of those ones where I was like, look, you've said it to me so many times, I kept denying it, but today I'm not denying it. I'm actually not going to deny it. And I felt it. It was like, God was like, you're not going to do it. But I said to God, I was like, no. It was one of those, like, even in the Bible, someone battled God. Not battled God, but, like, had an argument with God. And God was like, okay, finally. I said to God, I was like, look, today, even though I know that you don't want me to do it, I'm going to do it because you're the one who kept saying it. And because I kept saying I didn't want to, or I wasn't feeling it, or I'm not ready, you decided to put on somebody else. Said, no, don't put on somebody else, put it on me because today I'm going to do it. So I went to the people's, right? And when I said I could feel the Holy Spirit, the feeling, this feeling is different now. I was praying. And then I eventually just heard, go find them. I said, say no more. So I was looking around. Bear in mind, this is in Tramline. It's a nightclub, right? So yeah, that's peak of it. Your God is in a nightclub. God is everywhere, just deep down there. So I'm looking around. I'm like, wait, Tramline's kind of big. There's two sides to it. And I'm looking for three people when there's about, 200 people here. So I'm like, all right, cool. I'm walking. And I'm like, where are they? And I was like, wait, God, guide me. So I was standing there where I was naturally standing. I said, God, guide me. And then I just heard God say, to your left. I turned to my left. I just started walking. I didn't even ask if I should walk, run, sprint, whatever. I started walking. And I made it to one bar, like a bar table. And then I was like, where? And the minute I said, like the second I said where, it was like, I don't know. It was like one is crying. I felt like one of them was crying. And the other two, I don't know. It was weird. Like I felt somebody heartbroken, and I was like, who's that? That's heartbroken. And I was like, where? I was to the left. I looked. The second I turned to my left, they were just there at the back. All three of them. One of them was crying. I said, God, you are good. I walked up to them. I just curled, put them together. I said, look, after this, I need you guys. Either you guys find me, or I find you. I need to talk to all three of you right after this. Okay. So keep praying. Keep doing your prayers. Everything. But right after this, I need to talk to all three of you, okay? And they said, come. After that, I spoke to all three of them about their problems, right? And it was just different. I said, because the way I was talking to them, it was like when I spoke to them, I said, how are you feeling emotionally? Because I wasn't attacking them mentally or physically or spiritually. It was emotionally, because each one of their emotions was just peak to me. So that's when I felt the Holy Spirit. It was like, it was different, like it was really different. So the only reason why I'm doing this is because when the Holy Spirit is on me, man, I have to start moving differently. Like I don't, when people pray to pray still, so I can't stay still. Since I was born, I was just born to move, do you know what I mean? When that has happened, I was like, raw, God is real. Now I'm different today. I was feeling great. Like to this day, I still feel great. There'll be times where I just be thinking like today, I was just thinking, I was sitting back and I was getting deeper into my thoughts. Like, I have to talk about this. And it was annoying me. But I was feeling great. Till this day, I'm still feeling good. And I thank God for that. And there was an event called Disturbing Dublin that happened on a Saturday, I believe. On a Saturday. And one of the people that hosted it, Habib, puts on his Snapchat story that we need ushers. And I said, why not? So I put myself in, I volunteered myself to be an usher, and we got added to usher group chat. And obviously, Maggie, another person that led Disturbing Dublin, she would always do prayer calls, she'd tell us to fast, da, da, da. Like I was able to, at one point I was able to fast, but then I wasn't able to because I had to take medicine because I got punched in the mouth, but that's another story for another day. I got caught. Like I said, it's another story from that day. Came to Disturbing Dublin now, and they were just doing sound check. Now, I even need to get, this is the part where I need the Bible. This is the part where I need the Bible. Pretty much says, like, when two or more are gathered, I am there. But this is sound check now. You don't have to pray. Like, the fact that you're going to do something for the love of God, and there's there's two or more of you there, then that's enough. Yeah. But they had, I don't know, because I'm called Gleese. They had these drums. I'll probably ask one of my friends what it's called. But they had these drums that you put under your arm, right? And there's three boys now. And they're doing sound check to see if people will be able to hear them or not. Them three alone, playing a basic beat, I felt this the presence of God surged through me, and it was like, once it surged through me, I saw it surge through somebody else. Salt search, like, I've salt searched through Habib, and then Manny, and then Maggie, then TJ, and then James. I seen it just, you know, bouncing off people. And I said, wait, three, like, I, after they stopped, I sat there, I was like, wait, three boys alone, playing a basic drum, like a basic instrument like that, made me and load of other people want to do backflips. I said, nah, there's a, that's different. I've never ever felt or witnessed something like that. I could say that the presence of God that I felt that day was so different to every Sunday service that I've ever played in my life. I need more of that. I need more of what was coming through there. And their worship and praise is so different. It's like when they worship, it's not like they're worshiping for people. No. They're worshiping for the Most High. I've never felt a different type of presence like that ever. And like I said already, the type of presence I've got that day is different to every other Sunday service I've ever played or concert. It's mad. I've seen it on someone's story, and I don't know if I'm not gonna put it. So someone's story, they said the next Disturbing Dublin, there has to be seven. No. Like, I'm saying, me, I'm Congolese. I said no. Like, there doesn't have to be seven, because then you're just showing off to people that seven is this. Don't get it twisted. Nigerian people know about seven, all right? Oh, they rate it because it's different to theirs, yeah? But you have to remember that what you're doing, what you're playing is not for you or for the crowd or for the people that you're playing with. It's actually for God. So if you want something to be something that's for God, you have to remember that, and you have to stick with that, stick with what you remember. So, like, when I, like, felt that, I was, like, that's when I sat back and I said, whoa, what's happening? What's really happening in the Congolese community? Because in the Nigerian community, like, God-wise, people that take their God seriously, they don't mess around. They don't play games. They really don't play games at all. And in the Congolese community, there's so many of us that are playing games. And it's like, it's not irritating. It's like one of those ones, like, keep playing games. Like, if you keep playing with fire, you're going to get burnt type thing. So I can say last Sunday, just the Sunday service I went past, right? I have a choir chat as well that we pray on as well. And I don't join it at all. I'm going to be flat out. Flat out honest, I don't join that. Reason being, it's like the way it started is like, if you don't join it, you're not playing Sunday service. And I could still say to this day, I've been playing the Sunday services and I haven't been joining it because of my reason, which I've told you, which is trying to find my own way to get close to God. Do you know what I mean? And last Sunday there, I was told last Sunday that I'm leading it. The choir was like, yay, finally. I said, I'm going on mute. I'm not joining it. And I said it flat out, like, with my heart. I said, I'm not doing it. And they thought I was messing. Some of them was like, just do it. I said it myself. I'm not doing it. That's just, no. She said to me that that's everyone's reaction. That's everyone's past reactions. And to me, it's like, okay, but I don't really need to know about everyone's past reactions because they've already done it. My current reaction is I'm not doing it, and it's pretty much final. And she said everyone has to do it till this year, and I said okay, so I'll do mine later on this year because I currently, as I'm standing here, I'm not gonna do it. On this journey, like, just to sum up this journey, first of all, I can say God is so real. God is so real. I'm not gonna even lie to you. God is so real. And if you think I'm just, you know, waffling, wassing about, taking the mic, I'm not. Like, this is my experience. Remember that now. This is my experience with God. This is how I have grown closer with Him. This is how I have finalized myself with the Word. Like I said, this whole journey took 9 months, starting from the bottom, and I'm here now. Being able to be on my channel to tell you lot that I am Christian, I am taking God seriously. What I've experienced and what I've been through throughout my whole life cannot just be justified by any human means. It's only justified by God. Like, it's really different. Like, what God has done for me is just different. And anyone that is watching this, I just want to let you guys know that where you think you're gonna find God, you're not. I'm saying it now. Where you think you're going to find God, you're not gonna find him. What you've been put in your mind is what other people has found in God. You know, God looks for you, not for what other people told you. You know what I mean? So the fact that God put me on this journey to find my God in a complete different, in a complete opposite culture, that tells you something. That tells you something alone. And this is like a funny thing to me as well. I've said to so many people, because I found God in a completely different culture, a lot of people look at me and think that I'm Nigerian. I'm not. I'm actually Congolese. Like, chill out. We want you to pray more, press God more, look for him. Like, actually look for him. Because when you find him, when you find him, I said when you find him, your life will just do one turn, one mad turn like this, that not even you and your friends would realize that it's you. Do you know what I mean? If you did enjoy this video, I want you to smash the like button. I want you to punch it, control it, and all that stuff, yeah? Like, if you didn't enjoy this video, and I'm not sure how you did it, but if you didn't enjoy this video, then click the dislike button. That's really your own. And click the subscribe button. Make sure you turn on post notifications after it. Subscribe if you're new. Join the crew. I love each and every one of you. Yeah, you. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace. Say